Hello, this is Jen, and today I have a wonderful Necrons video for you. So I have my Codex here that I'm going to be taking a look through, and I have some freshly painted models as well. And I've got some work in progress stuff as well, and I guess I'm just excited to show these off. So in my previous painting video, I showed one of the warriors what it would look like finished. Now I got the matte varnish on it and popped all the little rods in there. I don't know if the old style Necron warriors are featured in this book actually, but let's take a little peep. I bet they're all the new ones. Softspoken because I have a fan running. It is freaking hot here today. I've got the window open, so you will probably hear like animal noises and vehicles and all sorts, but I hope you will not hold that against me today because it's just too warm for me to sit here in a closed up room at my upstairs. So, back to what I was talking about. So the style of the weapon now has no clear plastic rod. Well, no transparent rod. It's just painted. You know, however you want to have kind of a glowing effect if you would so choose. So I painted up the old style first. I have something like 40 of each style. What's on deck first is my warriors, my first warrior unit of 10 of the old style. I always think I should iron this background, but I always forget about it. Besides, who likes ironing anyway, not me. So my initial idea was to paint up 25 power of Necrons, so that my husband and I could play painted up game of 40K combat patrol size, like for Crusade. And we haven't had our game yet, but we're both ready with our painted forces. Also, I apologize, I have a bruise. I was helping my parents clean out a trailer that they own. And yeah, I'm kind of klutzy. And then I have some cat scratches from their cat. Here is a finished warrior. Nothing fancy, but I think that looks so much better than the plain gray. If you want a little more info on those, I will put a link to painting with you on the card. Okay, so my second guy I was working on in that painting video, which is an overlord. Ooh, I like how that looks on the video. So, did a little more here, right? There's more greeny bits. I did some gold. There's some rocks and a cute little scarab. And of course, we've got a tuft. Tufts are awesome. If you haven't tried them, go for it. You will love them. All right, I'm really happy with him. I did go back and do some gloss hard coat on like the orbs. He was a lot of fun to paint. So he was the next thing I got painted after the Warriors. Then I went to my Canoptic Reanimator. So very similar to the way I did the Overlord, right? We've got the glossy orbs. I didn't do any gold for the cartouche, but I might go back and do that because I kind of started that meta on my other items, so I'll probably go back and make that gold. Base. I painted like a Castellan robot. Honestly, that the like hand here does seem like a Castellan robot. And my husband is painting up his Admech, so this is like the perfect thing for me to have wrecked on the base. Also, I love the little scarabs on here and one inside of this. So cute. I was surprised to see there's like two skulls over here. And then I had the skulls in the like cathedral ruin. I just made those fawn colored as well. And some tufts. My favorite part is the little face. And tell me what you think. Should I go back and make this gold? I'll show you what I mean. So there's the reanimator. And the last thing I did for my first 25 power is my Triarch Stalker. Okay. So you can see this is what I'm talking about. I started to do all the cartouches in gold, so I'm wondering if I should go back and make that more cohesive. I might. So this was the last thing I painted up of my initial 25 power. I did the gem paints for like his trackball and the lenses and these controls. I really like how the ball turned out. And again, I did the gloss on the orbs. I really like how the trackball turned out, and I really just like the whole thing, and I don't know, I really like how it turned out. So yeah, I'm thinking that's the only thing I really want to go back and change, is to make that gold. But I mean, it's not that big of a difference anyway. What do you think? Is it worth going back and doing? Okay, So that is my first 25 power. I'm so jazzed to play with an entirely painted force, and I feel so much more invested in them now. I don't know, it's just such, it's night and day. I feel like I care about them more. I always loved them, but I really, really love them now. Now that I've spent time making them better. I don't know, they just feel more like they're mine now. So that is that. So that's my first 25 power. Let's see if I can arrange these in a good thumbnail. Let's take a look at what I'm going to paint next, or what I've already started painting. And then look at our codex. Okay, so for the next 25 power, I did the old style again just because I kind of want to get all of the rods out of my bits bag and being used. So anything with rods, I'm going to give priority. Okay, we've got. So I guess I could show the before and after with them. We have another unit primed up and ready to go. This will not take long whatsoever. I think the initial ones took me about an hour, maybe a little longer than that, but these would be very, very quick. I always forget what the names are. Let's go back here. Let's just look at our entries. I've said it before, but the Necrons have so many characters. It's crazy. I do have a couple, but we've got so many names. Zaris before too long. We've got a lot of cool guys. Let's see. Okay, so this is the Overlord, which we already did. When I come to it. So I have a plasma laser. He is primed. I still forgot to bring the actual can up here. It's called Miracal. I really like this stuff, and it goes on super thinly. So I feel like the details are really, really there. This is going to be fun to paint. I'm going to treat him like a treat. I'm excited about, I'll point out the stuff I'm excited to paint. I'm excited to paint like this gem kind of vial looking thing. He's got some cool stuff going on back here. All of these could look very pretty. His little eye is gonna be cute. And then he's got like a one tube right inside there. How's this go? Are there any little scarabs down there? Oh, there is one. Right there. I love how they hide a little scarab on the base. Me low pan energy.
Okay,
so that's him coming up. You got our warriors again, the immortals. Yes, okay, so these are not new, but they have that same style.
And I did start to paint those goodies.
So we had some green wash. We just got this set, the Army Painter washes set, and I wanted to try out the green tone. And then I've discovered after I started using this that I already had a Vallejo one. They are very different colors. This one's more like milky. And this one is more like forest green and more translucent, I would say. So just on this little thing I've been using as a palette, this one is the Army Painter and this one is the Vallejo. Army Painter, Vallejo. So they're pretty different, right? So what I ended up doing was I put two or three layers of this, and then I decided to try what would it look like if I put this over top, and that's what I ended up with. So here is what it looked like. I thought I would do a little dot of the bright green in the middle. Which I've been using this P3 necrotype green. So in the middle of the circles, I will put a little dot of that. Anyway, that was my different idea for how I could do those non-neon rot type weapons. So these are the immortals. They've got a lot of cool tubes going on. I'm kind of thinking that maybe I'll just do the smaller tube screen. I don't know. I feel like there's a massive tube in the middle. The two smaller tubes there. I don't know. You get to see the bottom of his foot. So there's five of those guys. I did the green on all of them. Amazing where they hide orbs in things. He's got a big orb in the middle. That'll be the toughest part, but it's not that tough. Ooh, like his little barrel body and his little beard. faces are more or less the same, a little different. There's two of those. And a ghost arc. So this is my big thing out of my second 25 power. So it is a transport, and it has a bunch of weapons out the side where you can like skirt out to something and shoot. This mostly painted, honestly. Okay, so I did the same style here because it didn't have the rods. So you can see what that's gonna look like with the dot of bright green. These somewhat move, but I'm just gonna leave them straight. I did the golden cartouches on here as well. Not glued to the flying stem yet, so I'm just gonna take that off. I love that the whole ship itself has a spine, because everything has a spine, right? Okay, for the engines, I did the Army Painter green wash on the inside, and I put the bright green in the middle. I'm not 100% done. I need to, like, that will be a lens. His dark ball will be blue like the other one. We're gonna have, I've gotta, like, clean up some stuff and go over some of the bright green again. But that's mostly done. I did this all pretty much yesterday. And I love how inside, they're not just being transported, they're being repaired. So you've got, like, he's missing a leg, and he's got a wound on his arm. Some of them have a little scarab helping them out. And some of them, like, he's missing his jaw. And I just think it's, see, there's some scarabs throughout. Great. I think it's pretty cool. I do have the other variant as well, that's like more of just a weapon. Quite like the pilot. Crown. Yeah, I know. There's some green overshoot like up here. I will clean that up. That's part of what I need to do, like down there. Don't worry, I'm gonna do it. When I was putting the wash on, I realized that this part right here really looks like a TIE fighter, like coming at you head on. That will probably be finished today. So just clean a few things up, brighten up a little bit of the green. It's been really humid, so the spray, I'm not sure if I'll be able to get it sprayed today, but with the matte varnish. Then all I'll need to do is like that lens and the stuff on his panel, and it'll be good to go. Finally glue on the flying stem, so it's not so wobbly. that is work in progress, but mostly done. Oh no. My stem fell off as soon as I tried to set it down. Okay, so that's what I've been up to. Have you been doing any hobbying? For the first time in quite a while, very, very soon. This week, I'm sure. I'm not sure which day I'll get to it. Oh, there's some people outside. Hopefully they won't be rude. Okay. So, let's get into it. After I have a little sip of my cold brew. Through the heavens, and empires have risen and fallen to dust. Yet all things have their time. And amidst the flames and madness of the galaxy's death throes, so theirs has come again. Okay, those people can really keep moving, if you ask me. I'll shut the window if I have to, but I want the fresh air. Okay, this is something that I want. Yet, the Silent King. Something I am so excited to paint is the Void Dragon. I think that's going to be so easy with that like chrome looking paint that we have for the base coat. I don't even want to put any wash on him. I want him to look blingin'. Also, we just made an order from Green Stuff World, so we've got some cool paints coming hopefully soon. I don't know how long it takes to get from Spain to the U.S., but it sounded like they were preparing the order today when I read my email, so I'm excited about that. Also, as an update, my missing pack of Modern Horizons 2 is on the way. Later this week. If they can get it to me ASAP, that would be great. Okay. Here is our cover art. To face the Necrons in battle is to stand against death incarnate. It is to know the terror of annihilation at the hands of beings who should be long rotted in their graves. Witch lights to destroy all before them. In return, the Necrons see only vermin, interlopers, and savages that must be eradicated in order for their mighty dynasties of old to rise again. Once 60 million years ago, the Necrons' armies might have achieved their galactic conquest with singular efficiency. Yet, eons of slumber in cold stasis have seen madness creep into their minds of their noble masters, as the stately dance of the stars themselves has scattered and ravaged their worlds. What arises now to reclaim the galaxy is an altogether more twisted race, scattered, factionalized, and riven by an insanity that has transformed many of their number into walking nightmares. The Necrons Necrons of the 41st millennium are a dark reflection of their faded glories. Yet they are no less deadly for all this. In monstrosity and madness, the Necrons are rendered more terrible than ever. Really good on the table too, because it means they're pretty easy. They're like a great starter army. They were my first 40k army, and I felt like they were pretty easy to learn. Now, with that being said, modern 40k armies all have so many rules to remember, and like auras and buffs and synergies and whatever. That, yes, it can be hard to remember everything, but I still feel like Necrons are a very solid choice. Yeah, so that's my two cents. I'm not an expert. I'm not a, you know, tournament player. I just play games with my gaming group of two, my husband and myself. But we have fun, and you know, I do win a lot. I must be doing something right. My husband has some Tau. He doesn't have a huge army, but he hasn't played with them in a long time. He doesn't have them painted yet, either. Okay, good. It stopped. Alright, we're good. Phew. Alright. Obviously, if you want to wear. Oh my gosh. Are you for real right now? It's beeping again. Oh, my town is against me today. Anyway, there's an Egyptian theme here as well as. Robots. You can tell with things like the cartouches or like the style that we have going on here with the flowing, you know, it's not really a scarf, but you get the idea. It's like the idea of robes. You've got the headdress, you know. There's definitely a theme there, and I dig it. I love ancient Egypt, I love mythology, so like this was an easy call for me to get involved with Necrons when I first entered this side of the house. I think the tomb worlds are so cool. It's like these floating mega cities which are acting as a tomb for a whole, you know, faction of beings who are just waiting to reanimate and take over the galaxy. And I don't know, it's just sleek and beautiful. I would really like to get a spider, but I haven't got one yet. I love how you can kind of get a sense of scale. I love all the art where you can get a sense of scale. Like, this is one of the monoliths right here. You've got some other floating, like, who knows. You've got some bigger things in the foreground, and you can see other things in the distance, so you get the idea of how big they are, but they're in the distance. I love that. You can see here's another guy down there. I'm not really an artist, but I'm creative and I can definitely appreciate something like that. Okay, so here we've got all these different groups that are awakening. Different symbols for the different dynasties. I'll tell you what I think they look like on an upcoming page. But there are transfers somewhere in my transfer area of storage. It would be cool if I can decide on a dynasty and figure out maybe putting some transfers on a few things. Alright, they have the usual layout of the faction. So instead of a pharaoh, we get a pharaoh. For a long time, I called these Catan, but I heard somebody call them Satan, like Satan, Satan, and I kind of like that. Kind of fits. So these are tiny fragments, shards of their gods that they basically have enslaved. And why don't I go grab my void dragon? Read about him in a bit, but this I really want to paint. I'm picturing like the body, the metal parts being the like shiny chrome metal, and then like the lightning effect here. I've got it'll either be like the bright green I've been doing, or I ordered one of the color shifting paints from Green Stuff World that looks like a beetle green, you know, that shining, beautiful color changing green that I think could be really cool as the like plasma effect here. And then I would probably do these like black with green. Green. I think it looks so cool. And in this case, the shard is being controlled by this Necron guy. It's like controlling the actual shard. There are some scarabs down here. Oh yeah. Lots of scarabs and skulls all over the place. So that should be fun. I do have a monolith too, so I mean there's big things on coming on the way. I've got the variant of the vehicle I showed today. I've got the big monolith, I've got the wood dragon. Okay, so we're talking about the different dynasties here. We have Sarakin, which is, you know, the leader is Sarek. Obviously, I do have him. So it might make sense to choose this dynasty. We have the Saltec Dynasty, which I think has a lot of characters as well. This picture is cool. I really do think that's really cool. The spiders flying around. Spidery scarabies. That's the variant I didn't show, with the huge weapon out the front, and it's like flipped so that these face the other way. We have the Nefrit Dynasty, Nefric Dynasty, Neolak Dynasty, Novak Dynasty, and then there are others. Like, you can create your own. There's a lot. Imagine this is like inside of a tomb world. And this is like the source of power or something. I like how it has the little like slumbering warriors. Kind of like how they looked in the barge that they showed. Stasis. And all of these. It just looks so cool. Okay, so the Silent King is like the big, big leader. Something or someone, and he's really big. He's got mega like spidery legs. I mean, certainly, I didn't go for, like, the black and all that jazz or painting the, you know, they've decided to go with this kind of brassy, coppery look for some of the warriors and such. But, I don't know, I like the way I did my hair. I do think it'll be cool to have a painted up monolith. I have the old monolith, not this new one, but I love how they did this effect of... It's a transport as well as huge weapon, and it's kind of like a teleportation, you know, they come out of here. So I love how they did a warrior exiting the monolith. Like he's appearing out of the energy. That looks so did this like geodesic dome looking orb instead of the one that I have, which is like a gem, and it's made out of that same stuff as the little neon rod in the warrior's weapon. I don't have any of the night sides or dark sides war croissants, but I do think they're cool. Thinking about my Thousand Suns a lot, and I love blue as if you know, but something is making me want to paint them 30K red, you know? I don't know, I'm not sure. I think it would be cool though. I do have Scorpec destroyers. Some with like one big weapon and some with like two smaller halves. Don't have any of these guys. They kind of remind me of the Plasmancer in the way that the body is kind of just a spine that floats along. Them big booty boys. I think they are chunky and I'm loving it. I'd love to get a few of those. And look at those weapons. They are thick with 3 Qs. I think the Hexmark Destroyer is cool too, but there's just so many units for this force. And I only have so much room, right? Okay, so here is the amazingly cool Zarek, the Silent King. It's so cool, and he basically, there's like 3 leaders here, including himself. And they're both named. I know they look identical, but they're different people. This is like his, you know, command platform. I think these are to do with like drawing a line between this and him, perhaps. I can't recall. You've got the enslaved Satan shard there in agony. This thing is just so cool. I definitely remember that he has really cool rules, so let's look at his rules when we get there. Okay, here's their overlord. I don't know. I like mine a lot. I don't think I did a poor job at all. I think I did great. I don't think theirs looks really any better than mine, in my humble opinion. And so that means I feel very proud of mine. I do think that this technomancer with the little spider is adorable. I have him on a t-shirt. I'd love to get my hands on some of these new flayed ones. The old ones were pretty naff, but I like the new ones. I really think that the other Satan should get a new redo. They just don't match up to the Void Dragon, you know? They need an update. If these were updated and looked as badass as the Shard of the Void Dragon, I would snatch him up. Speaking of, there it is right there. Also, I've got old and new scarabs, of course. Oops. And you already know I love those guys wherever they appear on models. So I love them on their own as well. They're really good to bog down other units, you know, enemy units. This is kind of what the gem in the top of my monolith looks like, except mine's that clear plastic. So let's see. See, they kind of did it how I was thinking. So this is like chrome body. And then let's see, they did the wings a different color, but I could just do mine chrome if I wanted. They have the plasma effect as like a bright green. And they did the stone as like a green, like a deep green stone. We'll see. But this is definitely on my radar to paint very soon, as soon as I have that one shifting paint. It's like Emerald Getaway, I think, from Green Stuff World. Then I will see if I want to do that for the energy effect or not. symbols. This one to me looks like, I don't know, a TIE fighter taking off on a runway with a sunset. So that is the Mefreet. The Mefreet have harnessed the wrath of captive stars to imbue into their weapons. This raging solar energy confers immense raw power and can sear through even the thickest armor with ease. Okay, at 3 inches to range characteristics, excluding pistols. Each time a model with this code makes a range attack, the target's unit within half range, AP goes up by one. Let's look at that. The protocols are a new thing in this edition. This is kind of along the lines of what I was saying about how things got more complicated in modern Necrons army. So, the command protocol. Basically, you have different it's determined on which one of these is going to happen in what round, right? So round one, this is an example. You choose them beforehand, okay? So after both sides have deployed, but before you've determined who will have the first turn, you must assign a different one of the command protocols to each of the first 5 battle rounds. And note this down secretly on your army roster. Okay, so you can put them in whatever order. I think you can't repeat them. So in this case, the person decided on round one will have number 2, 2, 3, 3, 5, 4, 4, 5, and up 1. So it would tell you what the different things are. Usually you pick one of the two directives, but this was saying you could pick both when it was the protocol of the vengeful stars. So let's look at protocol of the vengeful stars. Okay. So directive one, each time a model in this unit makes a ranged attack on an unmodified wound roll of 6, improve the AP by 1. And second, each time a model in this unit makes a ranged attack, the target's a unit within half range, the target does not receive the benefits of code. I mean, it's not the best thing ever. Okay, we have this one who looks like a little turtle from above with a long tail. The Nefric dynasty. Let's see. The cryptex of this dynasty adapted metagold to create what their Pharaoh calls the golden form. Their soldiery can utilize translocation beamer technology to transmute their bodies into living light in order to flicker across the battlefield. That probably means movement bonuses, maybe a little teleport. 6 up, invulnerable save. Can translocate when it moves. It's kind of like a run because they can't shoot. Each time a unit with this code falls back or translocates until the end of the phase, models in that unit can move across models and terrains if they are not there, okay? And again, they have like a particular protocol that they're better at. I think that's going to be the same for all of these, right? There's 6 protocols and 6 dynastic codes. All right, this one looks like a surprised Cyclops. Ooh. Sacred rites of blooding performed by their warriors in the ancient times, back when they had blood. The dynasty's martial heritage awakens a spark of violent pride within its legions, lending power and ferocity to their attacks. So this would be like the melee abilities. This is like ranged. That one was movement. Melee, right? You can kind of get the idea of the theme of each of these. So being grooved. Okay. The Nihilok Dynasty. I love this one's symbol. I think it looks like handsome Cyclops. You know, like handsome Squidward. So on this one, Cyclops' eyes open. He's got some eyelashes. He's got lips right here. And a strong chin. Okay, regal and arrogant. See? Handsome. Handsome Squidward fits right in. Regal and arrogant, the warriors of this proud dynasty will not give a single inch to their foes. They stand their ground defiantly, unleashing a formidably accurate hail of fire that cleanses the stain of the lesser races from the Nihilok's rightful lands. Okay. So they can control objectives better. They can shrug off some armor penetration. And they have their own certain protocol that they are better at. Okay. The Sarakan Dynasty. Okay, let me get this closer so I can read it. My eye appointment is coming up, but until then, I struggle. The Sarakan Dynasty exhibit a deep-rooted ability to fashion and maintain finest war gear of any Necron dynasty. Enemy fire ricochets harmlessly from their magnificent android forms, while in return, every blast and blade stroke in the Zerikan level at their enemies is lethal in the extreme. Okay, let's see. On a 5+, they don't take mortal wounds. That's really good. Can reroll one wound roll every time a unit with this code shoots or fights. Again, that's very handy. And it's Undying Legions. Okay, I really liked the first two, so let's see what I think about Undying Legions. Protocol. Okay, so it says, each time this unit uses its living metal ability, each model in this unit regains one additional lost wound. Okay, that's epic. That's how they regain models. And each time you make reanimation protocol rolls for this unit, you can re-roll one of the dice. Okay, that's really good. Alright, so this helps you to bring back more of your defeated unit. Defeated model. Right, and what did that one look like? This one looks like, I don't know, kind of looks like a combination of the first two, right? It has a little turtle, but the turtle has a crown, right? It's a fancy turtle from above, right? This one looks like a little dude. Like a little, there's his head, and he's got a crown in his arms. Maybe he's sitting cross-legged, like crisscross applesauce. The Sautek. Nothing can halt the inexorable march of the Sautek. These disdainful conquerors will stop at nothing to retake their ancient domain, obliterating any who dare to defy them in a storm of death and destruction. Each time a morale test is taken, you can reroll that test. Okay, that's really good as well. Instead of following the normal rules for rapid-fire weapons, models with this code, da-da-da-da, double the number of attacks if shooting model's target is within 18. Okay, I guess I'd have to look at what my weapons are. Honestly, Sarakan is seem like the one I would pick. Now you can definitely create your own, which is basically what this is all about. So, it says, your chosen dynasty does not have an associated code. You must instead create their dynastic code by selecting one code from this list. And let's see. Unless you select the vassal kingdom dynastic code, you can then also select one additional code from over here. So you either get two, or you basically, I'm pretty sure the vassal kingdom one is like on the sisters, where you can basically just pick one of the dynasties and act like that, but have a different name. Right, select one of the following dynasties. Yeah. So this is just mimic one of the existing ones with a name that you wanted instead. Like maybe you have some lore in mind that you wanted to do. Okay, there's so many stratagems and stuff. And then each dynasty has their own. Oh, this is a very cool piece of art right there. Okay, you've got like your warline traits and etc. relics, Satan powers. I mean, this. There's all sorts of cool stuff for that. And honestly, I think that the other ones, the Deceiver and Nightbringer, would be fun to play with, but I don't really like the current models all that much, so hopefully they'll redo those someday. Of course, they have their own Crusade rules, which I'll be taking a look at. Here's an example. I mean, you just saw mine. I'm gonna kind of escalate my forces like they do in the White Dwarf. But you saw my first 0.5 power. Okay. I did want to look at Sarek rules because I remember them being really cool. Got a whole page to himself. Okay, here we go. He sure enough does. Look at all that stuff. Whoa. Okay, let's see. So he's 23 power all on his own. So to give you an idea, what I showed you was 25 power. So he's basically the same. Alright, so he, let's see, in his best state, he has 8-inch move with 2 up, weapons and ballistic skill, strength 5, toughness 7, 16 wounds, 6 attacks, 10 leadership, and a 3 up save. He has an annihilator beam on his like barge, a scepter of eternal glory that shoots. Hold on, because I think the different, remember how it had like 2 other kings on there? Okay, yeah, so there is. I think it's this. Hold on, let's read this. I'm pretty sure the Scythe of Dust and Staff of Stars are on the other guys. I could be wrong. So there's some insanely good weapons. I'm just a little bit mind fluttered by all of that, to be honest. This is like serious. I'm kind of like getting tired, so I don't think I'm gonna read through all those, but if you wanna look, you can. Okay, I still, I do. do have these guys on my painting table, though I've kind of shifted to trying to work on my next 25 power instead of just going straight to those, but I did work on those in my painting video too. Alright, well, that's gonna be about it, I think, for your look at the Necrons book and my painted stuff. So, what do you think? Do you play Necrons? Would you want to? If you don't, should I change the Canoptic Reanimators cartouches to gold? What do you think? I should have a couple more videos for you this week. I did have a little trip to visit my family, so that's kind of why this past week I didn't really have anything new. Hopefully you don't